King Carter, King Carter, King Carter, iPod, King Carter, King Carter.
It's playoff time, baby! Ain't nothing gonna stop us from being world champs. It's time to show the world what we all about.
Yo, what's going on, Team IKC? It's your boy iPod King Carter here. I got the semifinals game 4 against the Minnesota Timberwolves. Kevin Love is not in the lineup, so I'm trying to get the sweep here today. We need to hurry up and move into the conference finals at the West Coast because I need to catch up to in real life NBA. So to start things off, the cameraman died before the video even started. He fell through the bleachers. It wasn't nothing that I could do to save him. So, you know, we're up 2-0 right now. And Anthony Davis is going absolutely ham. Now, we went on a nice little 10-2 run because of Anthony Davis. I'm going to tell you right now, I didn't have anything to really do with this 10-2 run besides dropping a couple dimes and, you know, getting a bucket. But Anthony Davis was putting on a show. Check out the Kia Slam cam. Oh my God. And I think that Rubio fouled him right there. I don't know. You know, personally, I just think that he got fouled. But I'm going to catch that nice little touchdown pass. You know, I'm a 6'1 receiver. But check out Anthony Davis in the paint once again. Now that completes our 10-2 run. But yeah, just to let you guys know, I am playing on Hall of Fame. And they came right back. I know I skipped through a couple scores and all of that, but this is the score that you guys are really going to want to check out. Check out Brewer, wide open, for three, it's cash, and I was pissed off. Now, at this point in time, I'm running down court yelling at Tyreek Evans, slapping him in the back of the head saying, yo, what are you doing out here? You killing us. But check out the nice pass to Steezma. He can't finish. I finally realized one thing. If Anthony Davis isn't in that center, I have no scoring option in the paint, which totally sucks being a Pelican. I might end up asking for a trade, man. It's just terrible not having a scoring option in the paint once you go to the bench. But check me out in the corner for three, man. You know, taking off the cape, you know, about to bring out the S on my chest. But I'm finally back in the game after getting subbed out. Now, we're in the second quarter. It's 9 minutes and 17 seconds left. We're up 5, and they have the ball. I'm trying to play all kinds of off-ball defense, trying to get a tip, a steal, or something. But check this out, man. They clear it out. Pekovic is in the paint, you know, just doing what he needs to do. And he just totally abuses Steezma right there. Even though Steezma played the best defense that he could, he even tried to swat it, but to no avail. But check out this play right here, man. This play right here kind of pissed me off because this is how the game has been all day long. They kick it out, kick it down, and just do all this paint work. We have nobody in the paint to play defense for real. But did anybody notice that my man got injured without getting touched? Like, he grabbed his head, now he's limping. Is he confused? Like, did he hit his head and sprain his ankle at the same damn time? I don't know. It looked like he might have got caught in a bum fight or something. But, you know, I'm trying to put the moves on. And Eric Gordon has the slowest jump shot and pump fake in NBA 2K history. Now, this right here makes me want to watch Eric Gordon's highlight tapes from the NBA. I really want to see if his jump shot is truly that slow. It pisses me off sometimes, you know. It's nothing that I can do, you know. I can't change it. So, you know, it just makes me mad sometimes. But, you know, we're up 43-42. We got the ball. And I tried a flashy pass right there, but it went off his back. But Eric Gordon does make up for that bonehead play that he had down the other end of the court a couple plays ago. Now, Rubio, I've been trying not to let him get inside the paint because I noticed if Rubio scores, then the game gets very, very tight very fast. So I'm playing like the craziest defense I could possibly play. But check me out, rising on that man. Yo, look at me getting crazy. Look like I'm trying to go Super Saiyan right now. I don't know what's going on, but your boy is spazzing out. That was somewhat of a real life poster, you know, that happens to real people in the NBA. Not no little animation, but oh boy. About to go to the line, give him the Kevin Durant shoulder shrug. You know what time it is, man. You want to know my free throw? Just know who my favorite player in the NBA is right now. KD! But, yeah, it's 51-44. All 3 minutes left, and look at me rise on Brandon Bass. Like, really? Like, Brandon Bass, you just let that happen to you? Like, and I moved his arm out the way. Showing my strength. Now, it's just a couple seconds left in the second quarter, about a minute. Now, I'm trying to put Mo Will in the post, but he is so crazy. Like, but the moves, though. Did y'all people put him on skates? Yo, if Johnson wouldn't have blocked that, or if I'd have went in for like a poster dunk, it would have got crazy. But we're about to hop into halftime. I'm going to cut it over to Rubio, you know what I'm saying? Let him say his little piece, you know, because we up 3-0 right now. Let's hop into it, y'all.
Well, Ricky, you seem to gain some confidence shooting the basketball in the second quarter after a slow start. Are you feeling a lot better now that you've gotten into more of a rhythm?
Yeah, I feel comfortable, so I start feeling better and try to do whatever I can do to win.
Ricky, thanks for the time. Gentlemen, back to you.
Ricky! Oh, my bad. All right, you guys. It's 61-56 in the third quarter. I'm running a nice little pick and fade with the homie Ryan Anderson, but he does not hit the shot. Totally ticked me off when he missed a wide open three. Usually he nails them, but this game he's way off. But I'm just trying to play a little bit of pressure defense. I'm switching with a whole bunch of guys, and I realized that Eric Gordon switches over to Ricky Rubio for the double team, trying not to let him get in the paint, and Sved took advantage of that. But it's 63-61. Anthony Davis, the brow, has missed a point-blank layup. But I come down getting Super Saiyan real quick, you know what I'm saying, blocking all kinds of shots. But guess what? They save it, get it to Bass, and he nails the nice little layup. Now, the crowd is going somewhat wild. They're just happy that the game is finally tied up. But we're going to try to change that right here, you know. Just going to come down, run a play that is somewhat not a play because you kind of can't run plays in my career. But Eric Gordon does get the three to fall, so, you know, we making it do what it do, you know. Just trying to put the pressure on these guys, trying to get them up out of here. You know what time it is. Now, it's 68-67. And I kind of got to go wild here once again, trying to find some open guys. And I find Anthony Davis in the paint for the nice stand-up dunk. That's what I'm talking about. Got to get these assists. That's how I move. I almost got this double-double, though. So, you know, it is what it is. Now, I got 26-10, so it's 78-73. And what I'm going to do is get him with the nice little pump fake, pull up, get fouled, step over. That should have been a four-point play, but it is what it is. Now, I did get subbed out, but it's time for the fourth quarter to start. It's 83-77. All I have to do is just hold on to these last 12 minutes of my life so I can move on to the next round. Now, I'm just trying to slow gun Ricky Rubio right now. You know, put him in a post, show him a couple dribble moves, and get somebody open at the same time. So I pass it over to Ryan Anderson. But guess what? He misses the point-blank layup, and I got to put it back myself. The 6'1 point guard in the paint, mouse in the house. Making it do what it do. Now, I got 33-10, got the double-double rolling, but the Minnesota Timberwolves aren't stopping at all. And with that being said, I'm not going to stop. The more pressure they put on, the more pressure that I put on. So, you know, I'm like one of them goddamn anacondas, and, you know, I'm going to put you in a nice little body chokehold real quick with this spin dunk. Yeah, man, your boy just did a 360, didn't get a replay. 2K, what up with that? That's all I had to say about that clip right there. But we do get the cookies, and I'm not going to pass it just yet. But, you know, I had to wait on it real quick, man. And Eric Gordon, he kind of pissed me off with that. You know, it is what it is. Tried to flashy pass to the boy for the open three, and he just destroyed all hopes of me ever passing it to him again. So, you know, I'm just putting moves on Rubio, wasting the clock, you know, winding it down. And y'all know what that post work like, right? Hit him with a nice little shimmy. Hit him with the fader. And you know it's cash, man. Come on. Post move score all day. But check out the me with the nice little ball movement. Tyreek was wide open, but I don't think he was actually watching the play right there. And I'm kind of calling for the ball, trying to get it back. And I don't know what Tyreek was doing right there. Was he trying to flashy pass it? He could have just bounced past it to me. Like, why all that? Why would you let him come within three? Now, on the next play, I pass it over to Tyreek once again. He gives it to Anderson, and Anderson tries to pass it to me and gets his cookies taken. So, I guess this right here is where Hall of Fame kind of checks in and says, nah, we gonna let this team come back. But it's all good. You know, it is what it is. It's 96-93, and, you know, I'm trying to play as much defense as I can, but I can't guard everybody. So, now it's 96-96. Fed is, he's only 2-for-6 from 3, but he's been making some great shots. And, you know, with the clock winding down, we under 5 minutes. The heat is on, so I'm very scared. I don't know what's about to happen. But, you know, I'm calling for the ball as much as I can, trying to get open. But I see Tyreek cut to the basket. I thought he was going to get that block. But he did come out with a nice little layup on the other end. Now, it's 98 to 100. They are up. And I'm just trying to play the best defense that I can. And Shved, he about to turn up. Yeah, that's all he had to do. That's all he had to do. He turned up. And, yeah, it's time for me to go Super Saiyan. Do y'all want to see me go Super Saiyan? Right here, right now. Hashtag just let it happen. Hashtag Super Saiyan mode. Let's do it. Yeah, that just happened. All I have to say is, was I over 9,000 on the Scout Radar? I'm just saying, was I over 9,000? Anybody? Anybody?
It's over 9,000! What, 9,000?
Well, I guess I was over 9,000 there. It's 100 to 103. I'm just trying to get us tied back up. Now, only got six to shoot. I'm telling guys to move out the way. I get a clear lane, and oh my god! I just destroyed that man's life. He had to hold me back. That's how crazy it get. But I do get a nice little shot to go off the inbound. I had to do it. It was time winding down. So, you know, that play right there actually put the nail in the coffin because they couldn't do anything with the ball. We getting cookies out here. Evans, I don't know why, but he didn't want to go all the way down the court and score. I guess the AI of the game is just not perfect, but I do get some nice shot defense right there, even though it was a bad block attempt. And we win this game. But all I have to say is this series wasn't easy. I think I would have lost this series if they would have had Kevin Love, because every game was a close game. Every single game. But there goes that Hall of Fame verification for you guys. Let's hop into this press conference, man. Let's do it.
Another sweep, making it two now in a row. You guys are really on a rampage at this point. Do you see this level of play continuing in the next round?
Come on, Ronnie 2K. You know what time it is, baby. We're going to turn up every round. We're going to win every round. 16-0, baby.
Man, I don't think you ever expect to sweep a series like that, let alone two in a row, and especially against a couple of quality opponents like the ones we faced. But we're definitely happy with the way we're playing. And now we got to figure out how to make sure it continues in the next round. I don't think I've ever seen a team this locked in, though, so I love our chances.
All right, you guys, let's hop into this conference finals. I'm going up against Golden State Warriors. The Warriors actually won against the Thunder. They put out the Thunder. The Heat are 1-0 against the Bulls. Things are looking up. So I guess it's going to be me versus the Heat or me versus Chicago, because I ain't losing. That's all I'm saying. But this is IKC signing out. Make sure you guys thumb up the video, favorite, share it, do all that nice little stuff. Peace.
Yerp, this is Siri. Thank you for watching and be sure to like this video. For more videos from this particular mode, click more videos. If you want to see more content from IKC, click subscribe. Oh, and don't forget to follow IKC on Twitter and to like his Facebook page. This is Siri signing out. Peace.